Hey everyone, welcome to Encore, and I was wondering if you guys know what these are. Yep, they're toe separators that you use when you do your pedicure, but I found a fun way to create something with these, and I created my Fappy-inspired brush easel. And this is definitely a cool and creative idea to give out to your friends as gifts, or to create for yourself to organize your brushes. So if you want to learn how to make one of these, keep on watching. Hey everyone, welcome back. So these are the materials you're going to need in order for you to make this project, and it's really fun to make. It's so inexpensive and it's very creative. So let's begin with these pedicure foams or toe separators. Now you can buy these in pairs, of course, and they're scents. These ones are 50 cents at Walgreens, and you can find them in different colors as well. And they also have different designs on them. You can get them in like Hello Kitty or Barbie. So I'll just leave that to you guys. Just be as creative as you wanted to be. And for this project, I just decided to get the plain ones, which are the plain white ones. And you're going to need two pairs. Okay, so that's four separators total, because you buy them in pairs. They come in pairs, packaged in pairs. Okay, so along with that, you're going to need a really sturdy, heavy duty photo frames, and make sure it's got the easel back in it, you know, the kind that has the leg that sticks out so that way it stands. And this one is from Bed Bath & Beyond, and I got it on their clearance section for 50% off. It's additional 50% off of the lowest price, and the lowest price is $3, so it's $1.50, so that's cool, less than $2. Make sure it's got a good weight on it, because you're going to need that weight in order for it, you know, to stand really good and for it to be sturdy for this project. And you're also going to need some white cardboard, or any cardboard that you wanted to use. For this particular one, I'm using white toe separator, so I'm going to need white cardboard. And it's perfect because I can just recycle the cardboard packaging that this frame came in. Moving on, you're going to need a picture, and of course, this is up to you. You can print any picture as long as it's 8x10 that fits your 8x10 frame. And you can, you know, print a picture of your pet or your kids or anything, and you know, just be as creative as you can. But for this project, I created a Fappy picture. I love this picture a lot. It's so adorable. I think it's so cute, and I'm going to use that. I think it's going to be perfect for what I wanted. And then just a few supplies that you're going to need. You're going to need some really good glue. This is E6000, which is a really good cement type glue, and it's flexible, so it's not brittle when it sets. You're going to need a ruler. You're going to need a marking pen, and make sure that it writes on glass. If your frame has a glass front in it, then make sure that it's going to write over glass. And if it just have an acrylic or clear plastic, you know, like a front to it, then, you know, usually most stuff works on that. But just make sure Sharpie is great. Just use Sharpie. Okay, I'm also going to be using some cable organizers. And this is by 3M. And you can buy these at any hardware store or any office supply store. Now these are used to organize your phone cables, computer cables, anything like that that you attach into the wall, and then you clip the cables. So if you find the kind that has the hook like this, and then the latch wherein, you know, you run the cable right there, and then you just kind of like wrap it around and hook it right into the latch over here, it's going to be best. And this is definitely going to hold my narrower brushes, like eyeshadow brushes and stuff, so that way, you know, the larger brushes can just go into the toe separators. So again, this is from 3M, and you can get this basically at any office supply stores. Okay, and then finally, you're just going to need scissors, all right? And that's just to cut our board. And that's pretty much it. So let's go into my work table and start assembling this together.
Hey everyone, welcome back. So when you take the toe separators from the packaging, you'll notice that one edge is curved and one edge is straight. Now this is going to determine a left and a right on the toe separators. So what you need to do is lay it out on your work table so that way they're opposite of each other. So you have a left side and you have a right side. Our next step, using our E6000 glue, we're just going to apply glue right into the toe separators and we're going to stick that right into the cardboard. Okay. Make sure to put pressure in it so that way the glue really sticks to the cardboard, and then let that set to dry. So let it completely dry and then do the same thing to the other piece and make sure to keep them opposite of each other. Next, using a pair of scissors, we're just going to cut the excess cardboard by cutting around the perimeter of the toe separators. Okay, pretty easy. We're going to set that aside. Now, I've already done this earlier, so this is the finished product. As you can see, I've glued in the white cardboard, and I cut off the excess cardboard as well. And again, very important that they remain opposite of each other, as you see on your screen. Okay, next we're going to lay this out right into our frame, and as you can see, I already inserted my Faffy picture right into the frame. And I'm just going to use the bottom of the frame where the glass and the metal meets as my guide. So I'm just going to anchor my two baseboards right there, and then I'm going to add two new toe separators, okay, by itself. There's no board added to it or anything. And I'm just going to kind of eyeball it and just, you know, strategically place it right into the frame. Now you can be creative on this. You can place it anywhere you wanted to. And I'm going to use my ruler so that I can determine the distance or the space between the two, the bottom and the top, and I'm going to make sure that that's even with the other side. So it measures about 4 inches. So I'm going to make sure that the other side also measures 4 inches apart. Okay, next I'm going to measure the length of the toe separators. Okay, with my ruler it measures 3 3/4 inch, just like there. Now I'm going to draw a line using my Sharpie that measures 3 3/4 inch, just like that. Make sure it's a straight line, and that measures 4 inches from where the glass starts at the bottom of the frame. Okay, just like that. That's 4 inches. I'm going to place a dot, and then I'm just going to anchor my ruler and make sure that that's aligned or in a straight line with the first line that I did, just like so. And then I'm going to draw a line that also measures 3 3/4 inch all the way to the edge, just like so. And then now I have two lines that are 3 3/4 inch long. And the next step is really simple. I'm just going to glue the bottom board first. Okay. And then I opted to glue this where the opening is against the glass. Now you can glue this pretty much the way you wanted it, but the top, I'm going to glue it where, you know, the opening is going to be to the front, because that's what's going to cradle my brushes, just like that, as you see on your screen. Okay, now do the same thing on the other side. And then once the glue sets and dry, it should be pretty sturdy, and just make sure, checking it, put a little pressure and just check that it's tacky, or it's already tacked in. All right, and as you notice, I also added the cord organizer clips right on the side of the frames, and these clips are going to hold my smaller brushes. And that's pretty much, you know, done right there. All you need to do is simply add the brushes. So the smaller brushes I'm going to add onto my cord organizer, and then make sure that it latches and it holds it nice and tight and it hugs it really nice. So this is perfect for smaller brushes like liner brushes and stuff. And then for our toe separators, it's going to cradle our larger brushes. Okay, and then you can just arrange that the way you like them. And as you notice, when you push it in, it hugs and cradles the brushes and it almost locks. Okay, so just fill that with your favorite brushes, and then that's it. You're done. You have a brand new brush easel. Shabba-dabba-dabba-dabba-dabba-dabba-dabba-dabba-dabba-dabba-dabba-dabba-dabba-dabba-dabba-dabba-dabba-dabba-dabba-dabba-dabba-dabba-dabba-dabba-dabba-dabba-dabba-dabba-dabba-dabba-dabba-dabba-dabba-dabba-dabba-dabba-dabba-dabba-dabba-dabba-dabba-dabba-dabba-dabba-dabba-dabba-dabba-dabba-dabba-dabba-dabba-dabba-dabba-dabba-dabba-dabba-dabba-dabba-dabba-dabba-dabba-dabba-dabba-dabba-dabba-dabba-dabba-dabba-dabba-dabba-dabba-dabba-dabba-dabba-dabba-dabba-dabba-dabba-dabba-dabba-dabba-dabba-dabba-dabba-dabba-dabba-dabba-dabba-dabba-dabba-dabba-dabba-dabba-dabba-dabba-dabba